again, an additional aha moment.
So let's just go back, if you are ready. And in the next question, we want to discuss the concept of blue ocean and big brand ideas. So when brand strategists will set in a big companies, they will make up these ideas. We just brainstorm, like whoever came and said, we want a brand with delivery or with quality of service or with trusted results. These are people innovation. This is how they can make the, take the product and position it the way it can be a blue ocean. So what is the concept of blue ocean? If you have too many sharks in a in an ocean, they will eat each other and they will fight. So it will be bloody competitive. So blue ocean, to make it sweet and simple, is how to spin your offer to a unique aspect of it, which people will come to you because you have this blue ocean. Nobody is serving this particular aspect.
So something special.
It's me only. Like Hyundai will be the only car which you can find your car. Mm. Is it true this is the only car which you can find?
No, it's not true.
But they will be in this. Like when we look at Pizza Hut is eat fresh. Is the pizza will come fresh to you, that's right? If you look at the pizza business, all of them are the same. And which pizza? I personally. No, Domino's is the deliver within 30 minutes or less, or it's free. When they have the fast delivery with the app, they give you a free pizza with the free because it's fast delivery. Pizza Hut is fresh pizza, it's hot, fresh. Mm. So. When you assign your service one of these blue ocean, what you're trying to do is say, I am the only one who can deliver this particular aspect. So Hyundai can be the one, which is the first ad we saw, can deliver what? Find your car. That's right. Although it's an app and but they take this position. Now, what will happen if somebody will come around this spin?
Come around?
Around this particular aspect and try to compete. They will be always looked after as the second entry. So that's why people don't compete at this level. They try to compete from.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's interesting with the Hyundai ads are all around that they're innovative and they're cheap and whatever, and all their competitors are spying on them and they're trying to figure out how they do what they do.
Yeah,
yeah.
Is that Kia or a Hyundai?
Oh, maybe it's Kia.
So the question I have is what is blue ocean in your business? What is the, your blue ocean idea, which is nobody can deliver? Other than you. So do you want to share, or is it not ready yet?
I think I said we have a specialized retirement assessment tool survey to guide you to a quality, enjoyable, personalized retirement plan. But I've got, you know, people think of retirement plans as the financial ones, so I'm not sure about those words. I was thinking, well, meaningful is, or maybe purposeful is better. Meaningful, I think it's purposeful and meaningful. All of these things are so personalized.
I believe personalized will be one of the attributes. But the question is, like, what is the blue side of it?
It's having a tool.
It's having the tool, so it's scientifically proven.
Well, I'm not barely got through stats, so I don't want to have to do all that.
Evidence-based?
Or evidence-based, yeah.
You say evidence-based if three of your, four of your clients have shown results. When you say scientific, it's probably got a lot more protocol, control groups and things like that. But if you say evidence-based.
Well, you know, I used to deliver Myers-Briggs workshops, and you get the people that they would argue with you. They want all the details about all the scientific, you know, background and whatever, and kind of like all the rest. You know, they wanted to disprove that it was as scientific as, you know, the overall general, you know, statement said. And I'm not a details person. I couldn't just rattle off all the stats and whatever. If you're in this book, you can look up and do what it says. So I guess my fear is getting caught up in that.
And rightly so. It's interesting because I go the other way. I want to dive into the details of the scientific research around heart math, and I always have to pull back out because I have to connect with their hearts and mind. And so it's a very interesting kind of problem you have. I would love your problem.
You're an
engineer, right?
But for you, it's an easy way out. Once you experience that, you find one piece of literature which is good enough. And you mentioned just to that person, if you really want to dive into this, then I would suggest to read this book. This will answer most of your questions. We don't have the time in that course. And you're very well prepared.
Yeah, we don't have time, take it offline.
And it shows that you know what you're talking about, because you know that book too. And then you just defer it so that they, there are signs for that.
Yeah.
And if they keep on doing this, then you can always go back and say, this is why I mentioned this book for you. We cannot...
I find people keep at it, but once you acknowledge, I heard your question.
Oh, yes.
Mm-hmm.
On the parking lot, we'll have an offline conversation. Have you read this book? No. That's another supplemental, but we'll have an offline conversation. Once you acknowledge their question, they're gone.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I find.
Can it be a methodology or a methodological approach? Because you use a methodology, that's right? A methodology?
Systematic approach or methodological?
Methodological approach, yeah.
Evidence-based approach, I don't know. Can you say evidence-based approach?
It's,
I don't know if that means anything to a clientele. Do they need to know, can you prove it to me, or do they just know that what you're saying resonates with them?
Yeah, the 100 people that I surveyed 75% say this or 80-90% say whatever.
So that's evidence-based. But will that appeal to your client? Are the clients interested in, okay, you know, 5 people out of 10 found this extremely useful, rather than here's...
Well, if I say 8 out of 10 of the engineers that I surveyed, the engineers will love that. Because then,
sure,
okay, but if it's 8 out of 10 of the HR people that I surveyed, they'd be like, oh, well, they're out to lunch anyways. So.
Yeah, they don't like HR people, yeah. Or 8 of the 10 people I surveyed.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have to say engineers,
mm-hmm,
right? But the question I had was, is your audience looking for the evidence before they will believe you and go down the funnel further? Or are they looking for, how does this make me feel before they go down the funnel?
Mm-hmm.
And I think you need to find out where your audience is based on the topic you pick.
Okay.
I don't know.
So you want to go ahead?
Sure. Mine was, the Blue Ocean is deliver a customized approach to achieve breakthrough performance in both personal and professional settings.
Okay.
Sure. It's deliver customized approach to achieve breakthrough performance in both personal and professional settings. So my Blue Ocean there is a customized approach in both personal and professional settings. And
Marcel, do you want to share yours?
The short version is the simplest way to start to eat your elephant, simplify with the support to start your journey to success.
Will they know what eat your elephant is? Like, is this, well, I guess it's the difference between your Big Ocean brand idea and a 60-second commercial or 30-second commercial or whatever.
Maybe you replace the elephant with complex,
overwhelming.
Yeah. Just for that statement, you're saying perhaps.
Well, if it's turning it into like a 30-second commercial, if you're using this as your basis to continue out, you know what the elephant is and eating one bite at a time. But I don't know how many people have actually heard that expression, because I've run into people recently who have never heard that before.
It's actually an old Persian allegory. But
the other version is personal coaching for business owners with focus on the mastery of how to eat your elephant in helping business owners to overcome the personal challenges that are blocking their businesses from growth. We use simple and easy to follow techniques and tools to establish and strengthen the business mindset, to create and implement a clear vision, and build a strong, supportive organizational framework for business success.
So the last part,
full of
I think the last part was just to something like it's,
mm-hmm,
it's a more of an action. That sounds like a Blue Ocean statement to me.
And the way you talk about simplified approach. So you are basically competing against a one-pager business plan. Okay.
I like the idea of simplified approach more so than the, you know, comments about one bite at a time, or your elephants and how to take the first bite.
Well, I think that's an important concept not to be missed, because that's what differentiates.
This is
the crux of it, right?
This is to connect to the overwhelm with a very well-known metaphor.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's a lot of those other, like climb the mountain.
Yeah.
Search
of 1,000 steps.
That's all.
Yeah.
All taken in other locations with other businesses. That's why I use this pretty well known. It normally it says like how to eat an elephant, you know, make it your elephant.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if this relates or not, but I really like, I think what's more common when we use elephant is this orange elephant in the room.
Who's the elephant in the room? That's the elephant.
Yeah.
That's a different one.
Okay.
So if you don't talk about the
let me cut through and show you this particular video.
Usually when you're overwhelmed about a concept, you don't talk about it. You just focus on things that are easier.
Yeah.
But to me,
identify
the elephant, bring it in the front, and let's dissect it. Would be the gist. How do you articulate?
Do you get the point?
So that's your summary of the book.
Of the
book?
It's an awesome summary of the book.
Yeah. So the idea of Blue Ocean is we want to get into, create a parallel market to the current market that nobody else is serving.
Right.
And you'll be the first entry level to it. So if the market is simplified, coaching or simplified techniques for coaching or for achieving results, this is the Blue Ocean strategy.
Yeah, the simplify is very important.
Yeah.
From our side.
Okay.
Is there already what we want so badly already? Is it something that's manageable?
Now, we want to go on number five, and number five we'll do it all together because. It's just the time is what?
Just coming back to the very entrance, when you said like at the very beginning, when you said like I'm the number one whatever, so yeah, I'm the number one simplified coach. The word is
yeah.
All together anyways.
Well, once you realize that you're a Blue Ocean guy, you're number one anyway. Right?
Yeah, but when you articulate it as a tagline, it's a different story.
Mm-hmm.
Well, this has really helped me a lot because I've been doing a lot of reading, like retirement books and stuff, and I'm going, like, crap, you know, like everything's already been done. So,
yes, everything is being done, but it's not done with your voice.
Yeah.
Like, I don't want to simplify the material because I put lots of effort in trying to position these courses together and this material. Like I spend considerable amount of time for preparation, especially when the material will be brand new. But right now, what did they ask you any new questions you don't know about it before? In this questionnaire? Like
this
is this
questionnaire?
Like the four questions we went through, is there anything new here?
Just the Blue Ocean was a new concept to me.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I like
okay.
That.
Now,
yeah.
Is the videos I showed you, these videos are available to you on your computer, by the way, because
if you know how to search for them. Or
majority of these videos are on the YouTube. But the experience and the way I put in my own voice,
mm-hmm.
and the experience of the three of us around the table, what creates this learning, and how we apply it. So no matter how much it was said there in the books, if you can read them and you vocal them in your own voice, in your own book, people will start to listen to this new sound. We listen to every new singer who sings an old song with full attention. But the song is not his, that's right? So no matter how much was said there, they did not have the chance to create the impact. So if you can take it and position it with your own voice, try to maximize the impact, this is what people need from you. Or this is the legacy you can leave behind. This is the leadership you can bring to the market. This is the impact you can create. Because someone was saying, like, 2001, I was in an organization in Canada, and we had discussion from the big funding agencies in the US. And they said, the knowledge, the creativity is not advanced anymore. There is no new ideas came or will come in the future. But funny enough, from 1999 to 2000, the knowledge have been doubled. Like the knowledge have been doubled in 100 years. Then within the last 50 years, from 1940 to 1990, the knowledge of production of humans have been doubled. And then the knowledge is doubled, like number of publications, number of books have been doubled in this last 10 years. And they predicted that every 5 years and every 3 years and shorter, the knowledge will double. Amazingly, with the explosion of Facebook, their predictions are correct. Because everybody right now on Facebook, what they do is they bring the old knowledge and they put it again and the production is doubling. But the creativity is not there. There is no new idea which will grasp the industry and move forward. So after electronics, there is no new idea. After the steam age, there is no new idea. After the communication age, there is no new idea. There is nothing will transform the human behavior, but still we have doubling the knowledge every 5 years or every 3 years. Amount of knowledge we produce is doubled, but creativity is nothing. There is zero creativity there. And this was the whole about how to stimulate the creativity, and this was back 2001.
They had something similar that I'd read someplace about, I think it was around 1910 or something, that said that everything that was going to be invented had already been invented.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, and then, you know, they have the TV and the radio and all these other things.
So don't be scared when you see material or information. But if you want to copy it, don't copy the images. And if you want to copy it, cite it. Like Big Ocean, we have the material. We even have the tools there. Like you can easily edit the video, but we don't do that. We say, okay, this is the word of the Blue Ocean guys. Because there is a book called Blue Ocean, Red Ocean methodology. So acknowledge them, get their permission if you want to. If you see any trouble, but don't stop because everything was said. Because people are not listening to everything, it's only you. So if people will listen to you and listen to everything, so.
You know, it's funny because in the personal development world, in the course that we taught, and that was back in 1995, and it was new information for me about personal development, and then I listened to Joel Osteen on the radio, and he's using some of the same quotes and the same whatever. And the fellow who was actually on the video thing, the one I taught in 1999 in the 1990s, he said, none of this is new information. I just present it in a different way. And he was very entertaining, and the way he did it just tended to sink into people. And then Joel Osteen picks up the same balls and he presents it his own way, and other people present it their own way.
And sometimes you have when you have revivals too, like let's say the Mercedes smart car used to be the little Isetta or Mini in the 50s.
Right,
it's a smart car now. It's the same concept, very very small car, but it's back again.
You know, the Zestafa. Zestafa. Zestafa is a brand from Eastern Russia, Eastern Europe. It's a very small car.
Yeah.
Okay, so we want to move to number 5 because we have 19 questions. So and we already 2:30, so we have to finish in 1.5 hours. So here we wanna answer these questions in the following pattern. My company or my service or my offer is the only that. So what is your service or your company make you the only one? So if you want to answer the question, what under my company is the only that, and what you do, how you can fill the spaces here. So what can you offer, which is you are the only one who can offer? Do you want to share? Or do you need more time? Okay. So, do you want to share?
Sure. my company is the only business coaching service that integrates personal stress management with breakthrough performance coaching.
Okay. Do you want to share now, or let's do the whole thing and then share to be shared after? Okay, so can you share?
my company is the only meaningful recruitment planning company that enables participants to can I go to 5.1 for my back?
We are 5.1.
Co-creates with clients to develop a personalized, more enjoyable life after retirement using clients' gifts, skills, and knowledge.
And in this case, co-working is good. If you say
co-creating.
That, co-creating is good.
Yeah.
If you say that.
That's the name
that's
of my
company.
Yeah. Co-creating. Yeah. Okay. I'm nice to fact, I still use my company name, which is co-creation.
Yeah.
So.
Marcel?
My company is the only personal coaching for business owners that simplifies the way to overcome the overwhelm and support you and how to eat your elephant to achieve your goals.
Okay.
In business success.
Okay. Let's move to the next one because we still have, it's like I'm watching the time. We don't want to be stay here beyond 4:30 at most, okay?
Mm-hmm.
How differentiation characteristics you can provide? Like how we do it in a differentiation ways? So one of your differentiation, for example, using hard mass techniques.
Yeah.
One of her differentiation using scientific tools
or
evidence-based tools.
Mm-hmm.
So you should try to write. The more you write here is very important because I will show you, I'm not sure when, but I can show you a way that you take these particular slides, this particular questionnaire's answers, and you create actually your slide, your actual presentation. We'll go through this sequence. So what differentiation you can provide? How you provide to your customer? What make you unique in how you how you provide it to your customers? Do you want to share?
My differentiation. I achieve fast results in the shortest amount of time by masterfully designing change management components within the overall strategy.
Getting rid of a bunch of my change management books, they're not that old. You want some?
Sure. Okay, yeah. Okay.
Just trying to clean out all my own stuff that I think I'm not going to use again. These are fine.
Marcelo, go ahead.
Simplify with emotional time and project management techniques. Support with sessions, one-on-one and group sessions and tools. Start the easiest way possible and succeed with implementing a clear mindset, empower personality and organizational framework.
There's one that, you know, I was thinking about putting down the same as you about delivering through coaching and seminars and webinars. And I thought, well, is that differentiating? It's everybody seems to be doing all those components.
I was going to ask you, what are the differentiating ones in
simplifying with the emotional time management and project management?
Simplifying with the emotional.
Emotional management, time management, and project management techniques.
Simplifying. Okay, so you're simplifying the three.
Using those techniques. Simplifying using those three techniques. With project management techniques, you break it down to the smallest.
So what you just
smallest.
Would your differentiation be? I simplify. I'll use the word complex for now. Complex project management, time management, other techniques. I simplify them for the purpose of what?
I'm not simplifying those. Then I have to reword it because it didn't come across.
But here also,
you guys,
here your answer is who is how. You are trying to answer how.
Yeah.
So you
so
are.
I simplify the overall problem. By using emotional management techniques, time management techniques, and project management techniques.
Could you just say I simplify the overall by using
a variety
of techniques? Because
but you're not making it very simple.
Well, I think the message gets lost. It's not about the simple, but the message gets lost because really the punchline is I simplify complex tasks.
This is explaining it more in detail with what I use. The other ones were the more the punchlines, things like simplify the way to overcome the overwhelm and support on how to eat your elephant or how to solve your problems, whatever that is. You can fill in the blanks for what the elephant is.
Simplify problems.
That would be the very short version.
I like your statement that's simplified problem solving.
Well, I just took the two words that he had, and I thought those came together really well. Because you can simplify complex problem solving is really it.
Mm-hmm. In a nutshell.
Because everybody does what you say right now is they try and simplify. I mean, I have a client who simplifies multi-billion-dollar kind of construction phase, and he simplifies it into processes and saves up 10%. You know, in the overall cost. But you have simplified complex problem solving.
Complex problem simplified.
Yeah. Or something like bite sized chunks.
So, yeah, there's still quite some work.
I like the elephant theme, but if you hold the elephant theme in the background and just use the words without using the word elephant, we're really kind of rather than repeating yourself with elephants all the time, but you would convey different ways for people to kind of connect. So to me, it's about simplifying complex problems into bite-sized chunks so you can actually efficiently achieve your end result would be the kind of gist that I see. Because there's always that for the sake of what? It's that I wanna get things done faster, quicker, more efficiently, spend less money, and I wanna be able to handle this thing. And at the end, I wanna see I ate an entire elephant. So, I don't know what the lion
was. Yeah, thank you.
Differentiating characteristics is evidence-based tools and research, and co-creating, which I think is different than what other people identify as. Help identify clients' gifts, skills, knowledge, and values to create personalized retirement plans.
So survey, I call it survey.
Mm-hmm.
Would that allow your clients, would that allow you to determine your clients' personalized needs based on the holistic requirements? Is that the tool you're going to use to ascertain that?
Well, no, I guess I'm taking a lot from my career transition work where you do identify skills, and I mean, you can have skills that you want to keep using, and skills that you never want to use again.
Right.
You know, so identify what you want to do and what your values are, and, you know, because that will have a bearing on what you
do. Right. So really, you're saying, are your values that you want to always use, and what are your strengths and talents?
And knowledge you can bring.
And knowledge. And forget about what you did in the past. This is what you want to do.
Yeah, well, you take what you did in the past that you liked doing and you want to continue on.
And
you
keep doing it.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, number three is, who is your ideal client? And when you look at number three, answer was it number four, which is, where are these clients? So number three will be, who is your ideal client? So imagine you want to do this for who are the correct, you remember this avatar, and the number four is where. And let's just go get more water.
It's a market segment, that's not a geographical segment.
It doesn't matter, it can be either or. And don't go forward so we can discuss. If you are done, we can share it.
Business owner, solopreneur, starter with personal challenges such as fear, low confidence or self-esteem, guilt, shame, anxiety, overwhelmed, English or German speaking, preferably family business.
Okay.
All right. You said German speaking?
Mm-hmm. English or German speaking. So I do have clients in Germany and Europe.
Okay.
Existing clients. And over here, they can be either English or German speaking.
Okay.
Yeah. pays off. Food, I would say.
Very nice.
I'm an international coach.
Brilliant.
For the differentiation.
I like it.
Okay.
Mine is stressed out, overwhelmed, small to mid-sized business owner with growth potential and too busy to do own market research.
What's the market research component on your ass?
If they're too busy to figure out where the growth potential, they just don't know where to grow.
Yeah.
And they're just way too busy to figure out where the next market growth is. Usually when they call me, they say, how do I do this? How do I position my,
mm-hmm.
my business?
Okay. You wanna keep going or
where? Calgary, online, offline, and Germany or German speaking countries for now.
Do you know any other dialects than German? Like Germanic dialects or anything?
Within Germany, yeah, some dialects, but.
But outside Germany, like Austria, those are people.
It's the same, it's slightly different as Swiss German.
Yeah.
But yeah, they also speak a high German, so.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
but Switzerland and Austria would be also.
Part of Europe.
Yeah, Luxembourg.
Very
part
nice.
Of the Netherlands.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Mine's, I said it's North America, but I broke it down into where I'm going to be addressing primary, and then later on as I expand. So mine is Calgary and area, then it's Alberta, then Western Canada, Western U.S., and then Canada, U.S. would be like the kind of progression that I saw.
Okay. Denise?
Well, I just realized, as you guys were talking, I just shot myself in the foot here, but my ideal customer was 50 plus, and I said laid off prematurely, and I realized that they have no money. So...
They may not have money,
or perceived.
Do they have resources? Like, for example, is there some program out there, a government program, that funds them to do what you offer them to do? That's the other one.
Well, the gal who wrote a book and came up with this retirement assessment tool that was extrovert-introvert related,
right.
She tends to have a lot of retirement. Well, actually, she does retirement programs for the government, but I don't think she necessarily has funding to do it elsewhere. So
you may want to find out if there's funding available for people to do that. I'm speaking specifically of the prematurely laid off, because when they lay off, they usually have a program that they kind of attach to the package.
Well, usually, like my experience is that it's part of a package. They're off, and the packages are getting a lot leaner now, because they're based on price, not what you get for the price. So if you have any kind of personalized stuff, then very few companies are paying that price. They're going to do it online, and no.
For the rank and file, yes.
Yeah.
But as you move on to the management and the executive, might be different. So you may want to kind of investigate that a bit more.
Yeah.
If that's your passion, don't get rid of your passion just because there's no money in it. You can find that blue ocean.
Well, I thought that was a good place to start, because I don't think
place.
That any of the colleagues that I know of are approaching that market. But I know that, you know, when I have been working as a consultant in those companies, they usually have somebody that does a retirement workshop. And I went to the one at the company I just worked for last year. And I came out of it. I was hoping that I would actually have a plan coming out of this afternoon workshop.
Mm-hmm.
And they were allowed to bring their spouses in and stuff. So I thought, hey, this would be great, because then they could talk more. I had nothing tangible coming out of it.
A lot of companies who may be looking to downsize or have early retirement packages for people to entice them to retire early, they could use your service, because what you're going to do is you're going to get them excited about retirement.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's, if I may be so bold to say, consider that to be a differentiation.
Mm.
And if you target companies with that kind of a moniker and saying, you know, you're looking to downsize, you want people to retire, how about getting them excited? Here, I can show them how they can get excited about retirement, and then convince them to pay for the the package up front, because it, in the end it costs them less if they have to early retire them rather than laying them off. So that would be another kind of niche market.
Yeah. Actually, that would be good. Actually, I guess ultimately, I guess it's because it's what I know is getting into corporations and catch people before they retire, so they start thinking about it before all of a sudden they're just thrown into it and going, ah.
And you have to figure out what the pain points of the corporations are, not of the individual retirees, because you want to address the pain points of the corporate people. And that's the only way they're going to get you in there.
Mm-hmm. And so, me being none too adventurous right now, I've got Calgary. But because
that's
where
you
start.
It's the market
I go. Yeah.
Okay. But your customers are what? Are corporation or individual?
She said individual. She said individuals laid off, recently laid off, prematurely laid off. What she said.
Yeah. So you have to be careful, because if you get your either, there's a complete different strategy for corporate. Okay. Now, why their main desire? If you go back to the last chapter. Why the main desire they will join you?
Why would my clients join me?
Yes. And if you can answer also number 6 will be when. And when?
Yeah.
Do you
when
sh-
is now? What?
No, when is when they will join you?
When are they ready to join you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
When they will join you? What is
that?
What trigger? What is the underlying? What is the underlying trend?
Okay.
Or at what age? Or. Okay, do you need more time? Okay, what I want you to do now, as you see number 6,
mm-hmm.
I want you to go back and write. My company is the only that, and you make out of all of these 6 questions, out of the 6 answers, a paragraph by concatenating the 6 answers together to describe how you can position your product or service in a unique way. Do you have questions? So how could you position your product or service in a unique way? Want you to go in this paragraph, in this half a page, and just concatenate all these answers together to make it a paragraph.
The six.
We have what, how, who, where, why, and when. So what you need to come here and take these answers and make here them as a paragraph. And then when you're done, we can share this paragraph. Are done?
No, I have to type it in because I'm moving things around.
Make it simple. The exercise has a homework as well. Make it simple. Just don't type it in. Make it simple.
I am trying to make it simple.
Can you read it? Can you read it? Someone wants to start to share?
He said, my company is building a recruitment planning company that uses tools and evidence-based research to co-create each client's plan by helping them identify their gifts, skills, values, and knowledge. My ideal client is 50 plus years old and has been prematurely laid off in the county area.
I love it. I don't know.
I would replace my ideal client to be four or we work with. Okay, and here, okay, let's just do the exercise. I know we are rush on time, but go ahead.
Too many business owners don't live their dreams and achieve their goals. They feel overwhelmed and stuck in circumstances, some living with fears, anxiety, and little confidence, or low self-esteem, often resulting in feelings of guilt and shame. Missing a strong and clear mindset and lacking a simple and supportive framework creates difficulties to successfully change and achieve what they really want. We coach and mentor business owners in a simplified way, online and offline, so they can develop a clear mindset. We provide them with the tools to build their own supportive framework, and we support and empower them to achieve their goals and dreams.
Okay. There are so many verbiage in it. There are so many, it's a little bit wordy. You can say it in a very short, more concise way.
Yeah.
What about yours, sir?
Well, my company is the only business coaching service that I wanted to incorporate, but the way I've written it, it has developed a system to help easily overcome overwhelming stress to business. System to help business owners easily overcome overwhelming stress to take the straightest path to performance by masterfully integrating change management components in the overall strategy.
To me, that, you know, when you were talking at the very beginning about, you know, the two different personalities that Mike has, you know, and
yeah.
trying to bring them together,
yeah.
this is sounding so much businessy.
Yeah.
You're focused on the business side and you kind of left Mike the home guy out of it.
Out of it, yeah.
You know, because I liked your initial little
together, right,
thing
yeah.
that. Because everybody can identify that they have different characteristics at home versus at work. And you need that. But it can drive you crazy.
You're right. I need to put more of that blended.
So when you go your homework and the blended at home, I want you to consider this particular handout. This handout has, if you go back to page number 4 first,
mm-hmm.
you always get a handout and read it backward, okay? Go to page number 4.
So
in
you're
it.
Chinese? You start from
no, you start from the conclusion.
Yeah, okay.
This is from 1991 book. It says, most the new sell, most persuasive selling words, according to record researchers, you, easy, money, save, love, new, discover, results, proven, health, and guarantee. Marketing Magazine has published some studies and said that the most persuasive word for selling, you, discover, easy, proven, save, money, guarantee, health, happiness, love, blah, 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 blah. So, if you want to go outside and sell your products, you have to understand that there are some words which people resonate with it in a different ways. And these resonations or reasoning will change from demographic areas, from different regions. So we talk here about North America. So if you go to page number 1 now, according to XYZ, whoever did the study, he said the 5 most persuasive words in English word are you, free, because, instantaneously, and new. Okay? So, when you look at your positioning in your paragraph, I would recommend that you start to use these particular adverb or adjectives. So, you instantaneously achieve results, or you instantaneously have a free. So you try. Now, if you want to go to the 20 most influential words, it will be suddenly, now, announcing, introducing, improvement, amazing. So we provide, using these amazing tools, we will get remarkable, revolutionary, miracles, magic, offer, we offer. Then there are the words which will make you feel safe. Anonymous, authentic, bagged, best-selling, cancel anytime, certified. So using certified techniques or using certified code or we provide certification. No obligation, no question asked, no risk, no string attached. 3 words to encourage community, join, become a member, or come along. Then, when you say, I only serve my clients, we provide service to member only, or login required, class full, membership now closed, ask for an invitation, apply to one of our beta tester, exclusive offers, become an insider, be one of few. There are 10 cause and effect word accordingly as a result, because, caused by, 9 phrases that imply scarcity, limited offer, supply running time out, supplies running out, get them while they last, sales end soon. Secret, tell us, inspire. And then there are these 48 ones, which is just ubiquitous power words. You see, trust is number 2. Improve is number 1. So if you provide improvement, you say, my system improves.
Now, is this like in order of priority?
Nope.
It is, eh?
Nope.
No?
Nope.
So how do you say trust is second?
Well, it's just
the list. In the second.
But
yeah.
It could be any.
It could be any. I wouldn't buy into the priority thing, because I don't. I kind of understand how they will, how they will came up with this.
Right.
But I wouldn't believe that this will have an order.
Okay.
And then you can add use at the end. So this kind of wording, you don't need to use all of them. Okay.
Yeah. Hire 1,000 monkeys at a typewriter. See how many.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yo, but if you.
You can add yours.
Yeah, you can add yours, because sometimes we sit and say, okay, I want to say it's amazing, or it's...
Simplify
not
on
there.
So I just realized that I missed putting in the why, the main desire, into my little group.
Yep.
And then one of the things I jotted down that I don't know if I'm unique in this, but I generally care about results. You know, I'm not up there just to, okay, I've got 15 people in the workshop. Yeah, I don't give a rat's ass what you guys do after you leave here.
It's not your why, it's your clients. Why would they join you?
Yeah, I know. Because I care about the results. But I said they will come out of the program with a tangible plan.
They can hit the ground running is what you're trying to say.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So in my little blurb, I say each client will, or you will. After
the program,
after
completing the program, you will.
You will. It's you free, because instantaneously and now.
You will hit your walker running.
Yeah. You won't need a walker.
Number 7 is. Yesterday I saw one exercise for sales which was crazy. Someone wants to sell somebody. A pen. So what was the sellable feature of a pen for someone on the stage with long hair? It's basically to tie her hair with the pen. That's it. So it's very interesting positioning of because nobody needs more pens and more with inks, right? This was one of very interesting positioning, how you position.
Did the pen have a special thing that helps her tie her hair?
No. It's just the way they do it is like as a stick when they do their hair together, they put it in, it just stick.
Didn't this thing show us?
Well, pencil spray.
Yeah. Yeah.
But how does
that? Chopsticks.
But somebody can get an idea and says, oh, I can go buy a dollar store pen to do that.
Yeah.
Why would I buy that pen?
Because she's the only time she's on the stage and it was too hot, so there's no any other option. So. Anyway, we go to number 7. Number 7, we want to state the distinguished patentable feature of your product. Or outline the specific steps you will take with your service to achieve the outcome your customers want.
You want this defined in the next 5 minutes?
Yes. I'm working on the whole concept of putting the program together and have that sequence in order to make
so
it patentable. But
just to explain a couple of things. Not all of you will have patented technology. So is it should be a proprietary technology. It's special. When you talk about the process, you should give it a wow factor. You should be able to identify why, if I Google you, I cannot find it. So some of the good words there. So you either have a patent on it, which is like maybe heart mass using a. It's patented for somebody.
Well, my steps would be incorporating heart math techniques, but I would take out heart math and just go heart mind alignment techniques.
Yes, but what you will say is I'm using a proprietary and patented technology or process
yeah.
To achieve. And then you should be able to list the steps.
Okay.
Okay.
So you're saying put a summary.
People will not come and buy anything out being a system,
right,
or a process which will achieve instantaneous results or immediate results.
Okay.
People are not interested to buy any thing. They only buy systems, step-by-step systems. So if you have a step-by-step system, people will buy it from you. So step-by-step system that you can use, personalized to you, it's a proprietary system. You can only, you need to say it, but you don't say it in this way. You can only access it through me, nobody else. And if you want to have system, step-by-step system, you say, here are the steps. Okay, in my models we have the 12 steps, which is too much. 12 or too much. Usually there are 5 steps or 7 steps, but because we sell 2 different levels, so in the 12 steps, you have the step of the authority, the step of the program, and then the step of the seminars, and you connect all of them together to be able to create the dollar value for your program. So we have steps. So in your program, you should be able to identify what are the steps. It can be 3, it can be 5, it can be 7. 12 is crazy, 9 is too much. Okay? So what is the process you will get me? I know for the retirement plan is there is an evaluation step, is right?
Well, so do your self-assessment, like, you know, what are your
goals? So there is a first step is assessment.
Mm-hmm.
Or maybe it will be the second step, I don't know, maybe you need a step before that. Then after this step, what you will do? You maybe do planning. After third step, what? So you need to come up with these steps. Do you remember the steps we came up with? Can you just share it? If you don't want to do this right now, we can skip to the next question, but just share with them what we're to, because I cannot. Okay, I will do it easier. I will do it faster. okay. I will
so
do it.
Things you got me.
Yeah.
I will do it faster. All right, okay.
The hook. Is it the hook info?
No. No. Is the first one is will be usually is the assessment. So the first step usually it has an assessment.
Okay.
Okay. And then we have the plan. Then the execution. Then the measurement. And after the after our measurement, we adapt. And then the last one is the maintain, how we maintain it.
So assessment, plan, execution, measurement, adapt. And
yeah.
The last one is number 6.
It's number 7.
That's number 6.
That's number 6.
No, number 7. This is number 7. So I will remember to use the missing one, okay? That's why I wanted to read it. So. Sorry, there is one which is adjust.
Measure and then adjust.
Measure and then adjust. And then will be adapt, which is will be the habit. Sorry, yeah, this is measure and then adjust and then adapted.
Which is a habit, yeah.
And then you have to do the refreshment or the
maintenance.
The maintenance, which is the mindset.
So basically keep the client's wallet open at number 7.
Make them ready for the upsell.
Yeah.
Okay? So if you cannot come up with your ideas has to fit these particular steps.
Fair enough.
The first step, anybody will come to you, what you will do? You will do assessment.
Baselining discovery.
Assessment tools.
Yeah.
Then plan or strategy. What you call it, you can call it whatever you want to call it. Okay. Don't call this is our playbook names. Okay. This is not for the customers. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
This is our playbook names. So when I do assessment, I will call it. In my program, we have the 3 days workshop, the brand masteries, where we do brand assessment. That's right. Then you can build a plan or a strategy. I don't use these techniques, but I use something else. But I'm just showing you that if you don't have any. Anybody coming from the street has a concept, wants to apply. The concept will be only in this area. The rest are these four items only. This is where your skills are. If you don't have these tools, you will not make it personalized. So you call it assessment, you call it discovery, sessions, you call it any other name. Then step number two is the planning tool. Is what do you plan? So maybe you plan to set up financial plan, vacation, like you can identify. Like for you, what will be important is you have to identify what's important for you. Is it your time important? Is to be in a specific geographic area important? Is to achieve moral or pleasant is important? Or keep connection with people is important? And I can come up with a fifth one. So if I come up with questionnaires to identify which one of these five areas, are they five or more, Denise, for people interest? I can plan and design. I can plan your retirement. Because if somebody geographically important to be in Canada because he has lots of family ties, it's different plan with someone doesn't care. They can make phone calls all the time. Mm-hmm. If somebody, his time is important, he wants to see more stuff because he's maybe feeling left out. So he wants to spend more in some time, we can put him in faster cruises. If sometimes is the money is important because he does not have enough money for retirement and he's more conservative on the budget, you can put him on a different plan. So I don't know what currently happening in your market, but what I understand is if I want to have an assessment tool for retirement, I will ask questions relevant to five areas. And then I will offer services in the five areas.
So really you're qualifying them for the price point that you want to put them in, essentially.
This is the sales side, but this is what I cannot articulate in. Like, I cannot articulate in my sales presentation, that I have to know if you can afford me or not.
No, that's true.
Okay.
I'm saying the intention is.
The intention is, so the tool has to have assessment tool. Now, what is the plan? So I give, for example, a course plan and a meetup plan and different plans. So you can plan with them and then you let them execute and experience. So you can get them to short trips. And then the outcome may be coming as a plan. So maybe this short trips is you can assign for them. You say like, you know what, we will get you on a tour. In 2 weeks, you'll visit three different resorts to pick up which ones you like, which atmosphere you like. And then you can measure, and then you can show them other alternatives, and then you can show how they adapt, how they can be part of this club. And then the maintenance will be how to maintain it, which will usually be a mindset or mastermind groups or some kind of annual subscription, so people can always have access to the newer resources. So if you have no plan whatsoever, you can adapt five or this seven. You can start with five, doesn't need to be seven. Because any of these tools can be combined. So measurement and adjustment can be combined. Adaptivity and maintain, it can be combined, that's right?
You know, it's funny because when you went measurement, I went directly to measuring training, and so I was thinking I'd do a pre-assessment. So what are your views on retirement and what does this mean to you? And then at the end, have they changed their viewpoint of it? And that's what they call a level two.
Here, measurement means post-assessment.
Yes, your assessment is the baseline.
One of my good mentors of our coaches, you know what's the difference between a mentor and a coach? Coach, you pay them, mentor, they give you for free. One of them will say, this is here where you know they are hungry, and here you can say they are more hungry. And you will fail if you have hungry people, don't drink, because he say, if I give you one beer, would you like to drink the second? If I give you a Coke, a bottle of Coke, will you be looking for the second? Most likely, yes. So if you have the good stuff here, people will be hungry for more. And if your program will not get you people to be hungry for more, you have an issue with your offering. Because if I teach you from business perspective how to set up from no company to a company where you can make $100,000 a month, you'll be hungry for more, so I can get you $1 million a month. This is just to, like, I'm not saying here, like, you will bluff or you will lie or you will not serve with integrity, because all what we are about is, I trust that you guys can deliver what you promised. So we are about integrity. But the concept is, if somebody will touch you, he wants to stay more time with you or not. If he does not want to stay more time with you, means he's not your ideal client, he does not have a real need. And the other thing is, you are not, you may not be offering what is right for him to keep him engaged. And just a quick question, and I'm not being mad. Like, when every event will happen here, we say, okay, it's over now. How many will stick around to talk with me? When we say this extra event coming, how many will come back? Because people are hungry for, why you are hungry for more? Because you can see a value and you wanna get the most out of this value, is this right? So you have to think about it from this perspective. If you are hungry here, if your clients are hungry here, in this post-assessment, they have to be hungry for more, not hungry for less, okay? But remember that the fees for them to go on the maintenance is much lower than the original fees. Because if somebody will only finish the program and they wanna be only on the mastermind group or the working group or the annual fees, this will be much lower. This will be maybe 1/10, one whatever, or 1/7 of the actual program. So you are not trying to drag their feet to get them to pay more, is you wanna deliver more value. So don't miss this concept. If I have my clients hungry, I will create them, I will make them more hungry, not because I hold my material, it's because I give enough for them to feel, yeah, we wanna drink more. We wanna, exactly like a cook. How many here can drink a full can of, a full box of beer if people will let them? How many can drink a full box of Coke if nobody's watching them? How many of us will have the baklava or whatever is on the kitchen table and you have the big box and whenever you go back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, by the way, you pick up one or two. How many of us will do this with desserts? That's right. So why you do that? Why you do that? Because you were hungry and you eat and you enjoy, and whenever you have a space in your tummy, you come up for a hungry for more. It's just a, he said, this is just a behavior which you can justify if your customers are really engaged and you have a potential of growing business or not.
This gal that I known through different professional organizations, she just bought it and built a place in Nicaragua, a little beach place, and so we met for coffee last week, and she knows somebody who's getting into the medical tourism thing, and she was wanting me to, you know, with my retirement thing, kind of build a business around medical tourism too down there. But so it's like, no,
maybe it will be part, we don't know yet, but maybe you rebut, but this is the point. It's like when you, if you don't know how to answer number 7,
mm-hmm.
This is our basic skeleton for you. Don't use any of the words here. You have to come up with your own steps, but along this philosophy. Step number 1 is the assessment. Step number 2 is, step number 3, 4. You have to think about the adaptivity of it and how to make it personalized. You have also to understand the concept of making them more hungry. When we get students in university, we get them with a bachelor degree. Many of them wants to go for a master, and some of them want to go to for a PhD. It's only the good ones, and the only good clients you want to keep. So why they want to go for a PhD? And many of them after the PhD will stick around for research. Yes, factor of it, they cannot find any work, I understand, but the other factor is these people like, they are hungry and you keep them more hungry. Okay? We go to number 8.
So when you said, sorry, this feature of your product, so that's the end product, that's not, you're talking about the big money one, because before you said everything else leading up to whatever the big program is, right? That's what we're looking
yeah,
here.
Yeah. This is what I'm looking for is the one. This is where, the, if you remember this line, when we say this is a big one which make you more money,
yeah.
Uh-huh.
And this is the upselling here, and here's the this is the one I'm looking for.
Mm. Yeah.
We cannot talk about the upselling here, okay? Because the upselling will let the people away. I had a lady from CAPS in Montreal, and she had a seminar, a webinar, and it was not selling. And I don't sell anyone from CAPS because I don't sell anyone in CAPS. Okay, but I know her and she has a lot, so I, out of curiosity, I went to the three links she shared. So she's selling a webinar for an online group education program. But where her website only talks about one-on-one coaching. So I just basically shared with her my wisdom. I said, your landing pages are not compliant with your website. Because if somebody will send you a webinar for education and you go to their website, what you will find?
One-on-one coaching.
One-on-one coaching, and there's a value of their coaching. She's like you. She talks about the process, okay? You can tell, like. She's exactly like you. She have lots of processes.
Is she single?
I don't know. No, but that's, this is the point I want to make. Is just, okay, so anybody will not show up for her workshop, for her webinar. This is exactly what happened. She has 10 sign up for the webinar and nobody showed up. This is her very first webinar. When I explained this, everybody got there alerted and they wrote me back in from very interesting message. I said, you know what? This is what I know it sells. If you want to sell, you don't spell out your services because people will go away. So if you spell out the upselling, people will stuck to the upselling. You will sell only the workshop, it will be only the workshop. Is the mastermind, is the mastermind. Is the four weeks, whatever groups you are doing, is the 4 weeks cohort learning group you are doing. That's it. The other one will be sold in the cohort group. With the time, the upselling will be known for everybody because people talk, that's right? Okay, we can fix it later, okay? Now, I want you to go to number 8. And I have few videos I want to show you, but however, we can remember one. Do you remember this Listerine?
Yeah.
What was the name? Okay. So if you look at any product and it has the wow factor, it usually has this patented process which nobody knows what is it. So any product must have a secret sauce or a terrific name. Okay? So ours was Beata, was Beata Technique, which is the terrific name we give to our technology, which we sell at Winner Brand, which how to put it all together. This is our secret approach. So you should name your system, which we described in number 7, you give it a unique name.
Well, you know, it's interesting, I've gone on to this One Look site, words similar to retirement, they got some really bizarre things, like Orso, like what the heck does that mean?
All what I'm saying here is, when you set up, when you write your 5 steps, 7 steps, whatever, you must give it a unique name. Like what you use? Heart mass.
Well,
what is the heart mass?
Why use heart mind alignment system?
Yes, but what's heart mass? Is the unique name for the secret sauce. What is DISC?
Yeah.
DISC, which is all of us will understand DISC.
Yeah.
DISC is the unique name or the terrific name for the process. That's right. If you listen to the advertising on tires, they will use this thematic technology, and if you use the one for soap, they have this unique ingredients, they have their names there. All of these are man-made words to describe the process. What this will do in a customer opinion is what? It will give it a wow factor. Okay? It will give it a wow factor.
Doesn't necessarily have to originally associate with that thing.
In
and
one
thing, halitosis kind of did with that breath, but that's what they were promoting.
One technology I sold very well was called HASM, which is hierarchical adaptive structure mesh. It's just a technique I used in 20 steps on video imaging, but all my technology is HASM compliant. And we sell the HASM technology. People came to us, say, like, when we go to RFPs and they have HASM in it, it's ours. Companies which are producing cameras and sensors for cameras, they will have a unique name. A pixel link. What's a pixel link? It's a communication protocol like anybody protocol, but it uses pixel information instead of data of random data. At the end, it's bitrate. But pixel link protocols, when you have it in RFPs, it's unique to this company. Nobody else can compete. Think about the same concept. So when you do heart, body, what do you say?
Heart-mind alignment.
Heart-mind alignment techniques. What does it mean? Now we have a conversation. So you should give it a terrific name. Okay? And the terrific name is man-made word. It can be two words combined, half words combined. It can be initials of every single step. It can be any random word. But the word is not used in the same concept as people know it is in the dictionary.
So it's just like calling Kleenex Kleenex, where they got that from, but now everybody knows that that is, like, it's a branded name. And
yeah. So you should identify for your process a name, because this is what you will sue. You'll go back to your statement and say, we use this technique. And now, this name describes the seven steps. Okay? Any questions? Do you want to keep going, or do you want to do the... Number nine, what basic ingredient do you have to play with that can produce powerful results?
What do you mean by this? Like tools? What do you mean with the raw ingredients?
Like, basically what you do. So you run assessment, you provide what techniques you do. So what do you provide?
So like listening, deconstructing, those are the ingredients.
Yeah, these are the ingredients.
So for me it's survey assessment tools.
Yeah. Blueprints. You have blueprints, you have ready-made strategies, ready-made plans. Access to resources, online tools, libraries. In number 10, and 10 is very important. List the benefit, not the features, that you offer the buyers. So in your time, in your examples are what?
It's a customized retirement plan.
Is it less stress? Yeah, the plan is a feature. So what are the benefits? What are the benefits you provide?
Peace of mind.
Okay. Cost effective. What are the benefits you provide?
I was just going to say fast cutting through the emotions very quickly and get down to the... But I was looking for something that words similar to pushing through or cutting through. So I, you know, it's all about how to get to your strategy very quickly, cutting through all the emotional fear and all the blocks, really is what I'm trying to say, in a fast, efficient way.
If you don't know what the benefits you provide your buyers, look at similar professional companies pre-existing,
right,
and you will find it in their advertising.
Likely, yeah.
Because I don't want to tell you, go to Google and type something like, what is the top benefits any buyer get from any service, and you will have them. I do have back there about a list of like some kind of list like this,
yeah,
which shows all the benefits, all the possible benefits that somebody can provide customers.
Yeah. I'm just gonna take a moment to wash it, but
sure.
Anyways, there's a list here. I just did the efficient, use the word
efficient.
And on the right hand side there, there's a whole bunch of words.
So for me, would be simplicity, higher confidence, elevated self-esteem, belief in what you do.
You should also have proven strategy, proven to work, successful, success guaranteed. These are some of the words which is not this one. There is another one.
Some of them
are, no, but this is not for this exercise. But there are, I have some for this exercise which I don't want to share because I don't want to I don't want you to sound salesy enough. So did you find good words there? So, easy to use, affordable, safety. These are some of the other words which is you can use. Easy to use, easy to implement. Okay. You need more time for this question? So you can have easy to use, affordable, fast results. These are the different types of benefits, which is a buyer will. Quick transformation, quick results, instantaneous response.
What was the last one, response?
Instantaneous or instant response. I want to broaden your mind. I want to get you a perception to that there are some tangible, like if you go to a university and you analyze this, there's something called tangible benefits and not superficial benefits, but non-tangible benefits. So tangible benefits, if you can sell on tangible benefits, people will buy quickly. Does it make sense?
Mm-hmm.
So if you have been doing this business for long, why you don't have this answer?
Who says we don't have the answer?
I didn't listen to it. Everybody.
To quickly shift out of overwhelm and tap into the full depth of your business depth, easily cut through overwhelm to begin charting powerful business outcomes.
All of these are features.
Not benefits?
No. All of this is what I'm talking about. There is a difference. There is a difference between features and benefits. Features is a quick shift, is feature. It's not a benefit.
Okay?
Finding the car anywhere, it's a feature. The benefit is you can locate your kid if you want to with whoever driving the car. Does it make sense?
Our feature is air conditioning, and the benefit is that you
comfort,
stay comfortable.
Comfortable in a comfort zone.
Fix your temperature.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So, if you want to work with heart-minded, with heart-driven people, people who only benefit with features, and you can sell them features, are people who are dealing with information. So if you only sell to accountants and bookkeepers, you can sell them features all day long. But people who are caring about their time, or people who are heart-minded, they will not be interested in the process. Tell me what it will do for me. Tell me what's the impact. Not tell me how it works. I don't care about how it works.
Well, then I'm stuck.
So the features will be, the benefits will be, is they can make more money, they can have a better life, they can relax, they can work from home. Is it feature or a benefit?
Feature.
So work from home is feature. The benefits is you can see your kid, and why?
Yeah, it's stuck in traffic.
Yeah, you can see your kid while you can work and make money.
So I'm automatically going into the area is you can reduce your stress. Is that a feature or a benefit?
This is a feature.
So when you say.
No. Being more relaxed, that's the benefit.
Yeah.
So you're more relaxed.
Being happier, rich.
Happier.
Oh, okay, so if you decrease stress, that's the feature.
Yeah.
Because of that,
the benefit
you're
is
happier,
the outcome.
You're
is the outcome.
It's the outcome.
Mm-hmm. So have better relationships.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why we talk about less the benefit, not the features. And believe me, everybody will be interested in the feature, not for the benefit. And the more you are in the features, according to the same fellow who talked to you about being hungry and more hungry, if you talk about your features, it means you don't trust that your program will benefit anybody. But you trust the process, you don't trust the outcome.
So if I say this will help you get better life, make you feel happier, make you feel more relaxed, create better relationships, you will easily breeze through complex tasks and challenges. Those are benefits.
Should be. But when you say
so
them,
easily breeze through complex tasks.
That's why I said it should be. That's why I said it should be. I did.
Because if you easily breeze through, so what are the results of easily breezing through?
Yeah.
Well, you're more relaxed. So
it's a subset of being relaxed.
Yeah.
So you're going to be more relaxed, but you'll also achieve business results.
If you say I will help you achieve your targets while enjoy your life and live happily after, this is all our benefits. Okay? Achieve your target and excel, or achieve your target and exceed, and live happy and more happier. This is all benefits. But I can tell you one thing. Your tone, when it comes to the benefit, is it changing? It's getting lower. I feel you are less confident In what, in your words?
Well, I'm less confident in whether I'm stating a benefit or a feature.
No, when you talk about, when we talk about heart mass, when we talk about everything about process, you will speak loudly, but your tone will get back. When you talk about, you'll be happier. I felt like you want to step back. So it takes some time for you to digest this concept.
It is, because I'm trying to figure out, how do I measure happy?
People don't need...
I know, but people, it's my left brain and the right brain fighting.
And the problem you have, the problem you have is majority of your audience are heart-minded, not brain-minded.
Yeah.
Are heart-centric, not brain-centric, sorry. So heart-centric people don't care about the logic.
Yeah,
heart-centric people will not come and say, show me the measurement. Where are the statistics?
Yeah, but in order for me to be authentic about delivering, I have convinced myself that people are going to be happier. And I do, there's lots of evidence out there, first-hand evidence that people are happier. Because
I will not buy on the evidence, because the minute you say to somebody, and this is for everybody, the minute you say there are some evidence that people will achieve happiness, what the automatic question will be?
Show me the evidence.
Show us the evidence. Or how do you know? Yeah, show us the money. That's right. So this will drag you to a longer dialogue than people sign up to your program.
So you just want to say, this is the benefit, but you don't have to have anybody, you don't have to convince anybody, you just have to say it.
You have to say it. And then when you go in the overcoming objections in the Q&A, you say, people don't believe that there is no happiness there. They will not achieve happiness. Oh, we have a studies from so-and-so which shows that.
Okay.
So you cannot just put all the information together, glamour them together and send it to someone. You have to give them step by step. You drink, was the same guy of the hungry, he said, when you drink a bottle of Coke, and he got the bottle and said, okay, drink this bottle right now, in one sip. I said, I can't. He said, just exactly for me. You come here, you sit, you're young, you're a passion, energetic, you give me all of this, one bottle in one sip, I will die. I cannot buy. Does make sense? Well, if you have a drink of, if she has this bottle of Coke or soft drink, can you take it in one sip? No. You can't. You have to stop. So there is areas where you try to overcome rejections from brain-centric, heart-centric, feet-centric people, where you can illustrate why it does work, how it works, what are the outcomes there, what are the results. But for this exercise, we wanna, okay, what are the benefits? So the benefits is you be happier. The benefits is you get more babies. I'm not sure if it's a benefit or not. But having more sex is not a benefit. It's a feature, yeah. Okay, because this is a feature of the program. It's not a benefit. The benefit is what you value as change and outcome, not the way to the outcome.
Like, you might sell to a certain crowd and say you'll have more sex if you this program.
So I should call them friends with features, not
benefits.
No, but this is something like you just have to untangle it from your wording, because if you will go and give and make slides based on this sequence, hear what my client achieved, and you just list the benefits. Okay? Hear what are the ingredients, what you will do. Hear what is your sequence. So this sequence of questions has a logic
right.
of a presentation. Okay. Now,
mm-hmm.
yes.
Because Denise asked me, so I had simplicity, higher confidence, elevated self-esteem, belief in what you do, proven strategy, early results, and affordable.
And affordable?
Affordable. Which we talked about earlier on.
So proven results.
No, proven strategy.
Proven strategy. To me that.
It should be proven step by step program.
Yeah.
or step-by-step system?
Well, that's a feature.
Because then the actual results of that is that...
It's the outcome, yeah. It should be the outcome. Okay, it's 4 o'clock now, so I promised to conclude at 4, but we have 8 questions to go, okay? So the question will be is, are you bold and daring enough to make a departure from the way things are usually done in your market?
This is like yes or no.
This is just an old question. This is like
yeah.
And if you say no, we stop here, pack up, and go.
No, it's just Jesus highlights that when you come and talk about the market here, you will talk in a different way than anybody else. So your discussions are in a different approach. That's right. So you are not saying the same. I'm not coming to say, I am the financial advisor. I am coming and say, I'm the one who will help you die with peace of mind because your left behind are taken care of. Are you willing to do this move? Because there are so many people are not willing to do the move. There are people out there, they still sell branding as photo and websites. There is nobody will come and say, it's a personal branding strategies, or what are the tools to help you set up your personal brand? Nobody wants to talk about your gate for brighter future.
So could you give a brief example of one answer to number 11?
One good example is one of our friends who will help you save your tax, reduce your taxes, and easy cross any audit. But she does not say that she's a bookkeeper.
Okay.
Okay. When an accountant will stand and say, I help you maximize your refund from the government. Oh, what you do? Oh, I'm an accountant. He does not say I'm an accountant. We had a discussion.
If I say, I showed you the simplest way on how to eat your elephant, that's something different than saying, I'm a personal coach for business owners.
Yeah.
So,
yeah. We had a discussion yesterday in an event yesterday, and the discussion was, how can you fund your business? So by the way, any of you, if you work for a company, which is not your own, you can basically apply to the government, get a grant to pay for this program. Which
for
is
for the business
company? For the Win Your Brand program.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, that's the that's
yeah. This
the
is the Alberta
Canada government grant.
The Canada government grant. So
yeah.
If you are an employee of another business, the government will give you 80% as a grant, no question asked. That's right. So I was asked yesterday, how did I build my business? My answer was I don't hire normal accountants. Because all you try to hire when you hire an accountant is what? Cut the accounting fees. I get accountant to earn their accounting fees. By going to the right accountant who will help me to maximize my grants potential and do the bookkeeping in an intelligent way so I can maximize this particular grant access. That's how we build technology companies. Technology is very high risk companies. If I want to go and the accountant will do everything. And I give them a quick example. I said, like, an accountant will tell you, get everybody contractor, subcontractor, because you are offsetting the liability and you don't have to pay monthly basis CBB matching, employment insurance matching. I will tell you, I will do the opposite. Because the government of Canada can give me grants for research and development on the technology for my employees at somewhere between 67% to 80% based on different programs. So if I have 4 or 5 or 6 engineers working for me, I will prefer to have them employees, not companies. Because the contracting will have 50% maximum contributions, and there are 3 more pages you add to the proposal, which I don't like. I need to write less pages than the extra 3. And there are also interviews and process. So people looked at me and said, like, so when you try to position yourself, not everybody is willing. That's why we have this question. Are you bold and dare to enough to stand and say, you are not an insurance broker. I help you feel safe and take care of you through the trouble. Are you bold enough to do this?
So if you answer yes, it doesn't necessarily mean that you have to come up with this statement?
You have to understand that this is the way to create the blue ocean.
You have to accept.
That you have to accept. Okay? Number 12, in light of all of your answers in the previous questions, what you would like people to associate with your brand name? Marcel, you want to start?
That I'm the go-to guy for simplicity and people-centered, so like putting people first.
It goes beyond this limit.
Hmm?
It goes beyond this.
Yeah.
So, what about you, sir?
I put down, so associated with my brand name is for people to say, Shamir's got my back. He helps me see around corners.
From your answers, I believe you are, number one is trust.
I am what?
Trusted. So
yeah.
People have to trust you.
Yeah. But that's, yeah. Are you agreeing with me or disagreeing with
yeah,
me?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, if whatever you come up with does not include trust, it
oh.
means you superficially was answering all the previous questions, because all the previous questions, we felt it like we even want to say you are the number one trusted coach. That's right.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. This is when even when we talk about so usually, you have a list of values where what people wants to. So sometimes it's creativity, sometimes it's leadership, sometimes it's different.
So for me, I put results worth the investment, trust and confidentiality.
Yep. And there are a question around a specific word. So can you repeat them again?
Results.
Okay.
Worth the investment, trust, and confidentiality.
So I do have a personal problem when you talk about confidentiality, because it's a fundamental ingredient. It
yeah.
must be there. It's not something to
trust, I guess.
Yeah, but if you will be a coach, you must be having confidentiality approach. If when you come and say we have dignity, what do you mean dignity? We deal with you with integrity. What does it mean integrity? Like, it's common sense. In our business, that's there is a confidentiality, there is a confidence, there is an integrity.
And quality.
Okay?
I think trust goes in there too.
You would think, right?
Yeah.
Not really, because if I talk about trust, that's your trust is something you need to build. But integrity is a foundation of you. You need to make me trust you. But I don't need to question your integrity. And you understand, I don't get personal,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah.
You understand my dialogue, okay? So I don't go to Marcel and say, do you have high level of dignity and integrity so I can deal with you? I don't go to Marcel, do you back up? He's with us since the beginning, so we have a good relation. So he will accept what I say, okay? As a good example, he will accept what I say. So I don't go, do you back up your word? Do you deliver on your promise? I don't ask him these questions, because ABC engagement, I have to assume this. So I do have a problem when someone will come and start to illustrate. Okay, this particular information. If you come and say, I have a high level of integrity, it means what happened in past of your life is what?
Yeah.
You didn't have any. When you say, I back up my words, I back up my promise, we don't say that. We say
a guarantee.
We will come to the guarantees, but we'll say, yeah, I did lots of handshake deals which went through in my life. I never say I back up my words or I fulfill my promises. Because this is, yeah. So when you talk about we are trusted sources, because trust needs to be built, but integrity does not need to be found. It must exist. And this is my personal view.
And so for me, for the confidentiality, you demonstrate confidentiality and that helps build trust.
But if you come and say we have trust and the customers first, is different than you talk about confidentiality. If you have trust and customer first.
Well, I think for me, the reason why I put confidentiality in is because in most workshops, that's one of the first things that comes up. And even, you know, in this group, you know, you mentioned it several times that, you know, what happens in this group stays in the group kind of things. There's a confidentiality agreement.
Yeah, there is a consent of confidentiality, but I would never in my life. Mm-hmm. I don't think in my life I will have a business where I say my top value is confidentiality or integrity or dignity, because this comes with me. This is what's my promises.
So it's like I will work hard at earning your trust is enough if you say that.
Yeah. So if I'm a trusted resource or trusted, because we work hard to earn and keep your trust. But I will not work hard to be
confident.
Integrity or dignity. Okay? It's very common in health services to have these particular words. Okay? Now, number 13, based on that, what performance claim you make about unique value that you provide that has not and is not being made in your industry, that the buyer will learn for. Okay. So, what unique value you provide? Do you have answers or you want my answers? Can you share?
I just said my clients receive more value than their investment in my services.
So this means cost effective.
It means better return on investment, not cost effective. Not cheap.
Okay, so you can say high return on investment?
Sure.
Okay. Any other volunteers? Okay.
I will go back to my earlier one slide. The simplest way to overcome your obstacles, or the simplest way.
Usually, here we talk about we provide a blueprint, a result proven strategy. We provide a blueprint. We provide a step by step systems. We provide. So, this is our. The unique values which nobody else is providing in the market. So if you provide a blueprint for the process,
this is the process.
Yeah. We provide
the steps of the process.
Yeah, the blueprint is. Yeah, so you can have a blueprint. You can have a step-by-step programs. You can have an online tools, which is nobody else. We have a unique assessment tools. Number 14 comes back to the guarantees. So, and I want to talk to you here about guarantees. Like anything in life, people will not invest if they don't guarantee the results. Because people, they don't know you, and they are not interested in your service. That's right. There is a difference between you sell somebody something they want, and you have, you give them a warm feeling so they can actually get their credit card from their pocket and pay for it. So what are your guarantees? First of all, can you guarantee your results?
Well,
can you
guarantee?
The question will be is, what's your brand is? What, when we talk about the brand first, what was the brand? Was two things.
Value.
Was promise.
Promise.
And
experience.
Mm-hmm. Which one can you guarantee in these two terms?
Experience, for sure.
You can guarantee a promise.
Can you guarantee a promise?
I think so.
Well, I would think that's where the disclaimer comes in, because they cannot, you can promise all you want, but if they're not going to do any action, you can't keep your promise if they don't do the action.
Just be careful, we are recording. So this that's why I don't want anybody around here. So this is, and this is exactly the point, exactly what she's saying. Can you guarantee the promise? My promise, when you come to me, you will make $1 million. Can I guarantee that?
Well, can you say that as a promise?
Any real estate investor will tell you that. Will tell you, if you invest with us, we will guarantee that you'll triple your money or whatever in 6 months or less.
They're not allowed to guarantee that.
Okay.
In the
this is their promise. This is their promise.
We promise to...
Okay. They promise that you make more money.
Right. They promise that you will not... So One private equity investor I know says, we promise you will not have to go through the ups and downs of the equity markets because you're private investing.
This is experience.
Right.
So he guarantees the experience. He does not guarantee the promise. So when I come and say, I want to pick up examples. It's just, the promise is when I get through your system, what I will achieve in a utopia status, in the best conditions.
That's
this is a promise.
That's a promise, okay.
Can I guarantee this promise?
Okay, no, because it doesn't happen for everybody.
It doesn't happen for everybody. As a matter of fact, the same fellow who gave me the Coke one sip example, he told me very interesting information. He said he designed so many programs for so many speakers. And he said that it's about 7% who applied the program in 5 years, they will see results. So 7% of the people who will stay in the program for 5 years, the most likely they will see the same results they promised. So the question was, how many will leave in 2 to 3 years? He said 80%. So when I do the math, 20% times 7 is 1.4. That's it. So for every 100, there is less than 2 will see the results they promise if they stay for 5 years. So, because we keep asking questions about this investment program, this, that. So when you look at guarantees, you consider it in two levels. You want to guarantee the experience, or you want to guarantee the promise. In some notations, you can guarantee the promise. When you carve it, or you give a caveat of that the promise, if you don't do your homework, it will not be achieved. Many people will come and you sign the program and say, okay, it does not work for me. Can you give me my money back? So they sit with you and they do the hard sale and they will show you that you did not do your homework. I don't do that, by the way. But people do that. So when you have the disclaimers around the promise, because if you guarantee a promise does not deliver, like exactly like the cereal, the Kellogg's, when they say they will overcome SARS using the Rice Krisp.
Right.
That's right?
Ebola, I think it was.
Yeah, something.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah. boost your immune system is what they say.
Yeah,
yeah, boost the
immune system.
So this is a promise.
Right.
But when I will tell you, you will feel refreshed. I guarantee refreshment, or I guarantee happiness. When you eat it, you talk about the experience. So majority of the guarantees in the market are on experience. Satisfaction guaranteed is a very misleading guarantees, by the way, because there is no quantification for satisfaction. Okay? So this one was open-ended.
So if I guarantee full money back after first session, if you don't, if you're not satisfied after my first business coaching session, you get a full money back. Is that based on, that's based on experience, isn't it? That's an experience.
Because anybody will be ridiculously, I cannot say it even. I don't see anybody will see you selling four sessions and they will believe they will achieve the four results in one session. This will be fooling, so fooling people. So,
yeah.
So when you guarantee the experience,
yeah,
you guarantee the delivery, you guarantee the engagement, you
right.
guarantee happiness, you guarantee that you will achieve results.
Right.
But you never guarantee the promise.
Okay.
And from now till we meet again, this will be a question for you. How many guarantees will you hear? And when you think about it, are these guarantees for the experience or for the promise? So I can guarantee prompt response. I can guarantee I will be here for you whenever you need me. Do I guarantee if I am here for you whenever you need me that I'll be useful for you? That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. But we also understand that when we do this business, any small shift in people's life will show a quick result. So we are with integrity, promise, and we deliver on our promise. But be careful with the guarantees.
I guarantee you'll bite the elephant's tail off.
Yeah. You'll start at the tail.
No, I make notes. I haven't worked with them. I put it in regards to the experience.
Yeah.
I have a few words from the next one.
So one, there is one which called maximize your success potential. Less cost, less stress. Okay, these are some of the guarantees.
But maximize your success potential?
Yes.
How do you guarantee that?
I'm maximizing your success potential. I'm not maximizing your success.
Potential.
There's a potential, yeah. Because this particular business was dealing with specifics which is much difficult to guarantee.
And what are the other ones?
This was less cost, less stress.
That's a good point, because I mean I can guarantee less stress very quickly. I mean, I can even measure it with the technology, so I can show them right in there. So I guarantee you less stress. Boom, it's done.
What is a positive word for less stress? Like, less stress is a negative word. It's less and stress. Less. So, less stress is
more
like...
ease.
More ease,
yeah.
More
ease. I don't think this is an English word you want to use.
Right, because disease is what comes from.
Yeah. So, less stress, it sounds like you negate the negation.
Yeah.
So, you get to a positive. If you want to, you are a logic guy, you understand this. Okay? You are a process guy. So the question will be is, if what is the positive way to say less stress? And this one, we talk about fine-tuning. So at least today we achieve that you have an about in your Facebook page or in your website. Because the about was actually question number 6.
About
your business. Question number 6 is what your business is doing, that's right.
How could you position your product or service in a unique way?
Yeah. When you answer all the questions together.
Yeah, oh, I see what you mean.
That's right.
Yeah.
And now you have the guarantees. And the question is how to can fine tune. So money back guaranteed, I don't like it. I do it, but I don't like it. Sometimes you say, if the system does not work for you, I will give you a free sessions. So sometimes you try to avoid the money back guarantees. I do it. For me, I do it because for me, I wanna only work with people who can see the value of what I'm doing and people who are willing to work on to take this journey with me.
Yeah.
And the people who are just here for paying me money, I don't like them. Because I'm not here for, I'm here for the value. And I know that my message will go beyond anybody because people, when they achieve and see the results, the people will be coming. But, so money back guaranteed, you may wanna do it, you may not wanna do it. High return of investment, or the this is the lowest investment for the highest possible return. You can say it in this way. Low cost guarantee is this when stores in town here you can compete, which is against
that's too
low. Like yeah, like 5% lower than this is 5%.
Yeah.
Sometimes you don't say money back guaranteed. You say you subscribe to my program. If you don't like it, which is the experience,
yeah,
you can get your money back. But if it does not work for you after the first session, I will work personally with you, and my cost per hour is that much. It will be free till it works for you.
But what happens if they're still not investing any effort into doing it? You could be working.
Okay, I love this question. I love this question. So the same guy who gave me the test, by the way, he passed away 2 years ago, this individual.
Mm-hmm.
He gave me the question about the one sip of the bottle of Coke. He said the following. I will, because I was like Shamir, I was very negative about everything, very rejecting, very rejecting about everything. And I was looking for how things will work at the greatest level details.
Mm-hmm.
Because I was a researcher. So I don't trust anything, I don't accept anything, I'm just don't want to know how it works. So he said, okay, let's look at this following example. You will come to me and you will see the success in the whole group, which can be 2 or 3, but you are not successful. So what you will do is you will dim yourself out. You will be, they will be usually shy to come to talk to you because they will have feeling of guilt. So they will never call you back. They will walk away.
But what if they don't? Then
because they will be dimmed. Like we went together to some mindset groups and there was ladies on the table saying, I got so depressed with your success on a bi-weekly basis. I cannot boot with it.
Huh.
And he laughed because he knows her. I said, what do you mean? I'm here. I believe like when I share with you some of my success, some of my awards, this basically motivates you. But for some people it will be the opposite.
Yeah.
It's overwhelming. So these people will stop coming to the program. So he challenged me, he said, how many of them will call you back to even ask you for their money back. That's why if you subscribe to any programs and you don't show up and you don't call, they will keep charging your credit card and they will never call you. I call you, that's right. I text you, I say, yeah, just to let us know if you don't want to come over, I'm not coming today, it's okay, it's very fine. But because I care, I call. But in a standard practice, in a large volume of clients, they will not call. And if they call you once, if you will call them once or twice and they don't respond, they will not call you. Because they put you on this status where you are unsatisfied, unhappy, but you will not ask you for, or you cannot ask for the money back. Now, saying so, this was pre-internet, pre-Yelp, pre-social media. In social media age, you have to be careful because some of them can go and just put a couple of things which can just fire you out. I just did it for somebody. Because sometimes when you got really, when you hit someone, you have to make sure. When you hit someone, He does not really get angry to a level where he just say, flip the table.
Mm-hmm.
I sometimes got so angry at this level, which is not right. But this is one of my weaknesses, okay? So when you consider saying money back guaranteed, people can come and say, oh, can you get money back? But if you say, I will work with you personally if you don't achieve the results, and I am a low performer, I am sick of the program, I don't want to see you anymore. Will I call you to get more of you one-on-one?
Probably not.
Most likely not.
No.
Okay. So based on where is your stages, but this is our psychology. Now, this psychology changed in 2014 when the social media became, like, I believe in 2014, it became like air for everybody.
Okay.
So, like an air, people will smell it. And this, by the way, only in our society. Like the visitors and the clients, so I have a client in Jordan, and she came here for a visit last week, and she gave me lessons in privacy. She does not even have her photo. She's a business coach. She does not have a photo. When she got, she went around and she got this mortgage brokers and the realtor brokers with their ladies' photos on the business cards. She was amazed. She said, oh, do you really? I said, yeah. I said, like, I know in your country, if you print your photo on your business card, it means you are looking for a husband. That's it. She said, yes. So you don't, if you want to expand beyond Canada, you have to understand the culture. But only limited to North America, which is Canada, US, 60% of us are on social media right now. And this 60% or 80% are dangerous, because if you want to sell someone and he is not satisfied, he can kill you online. So you have to be careful. But if you provide guarantees, to cut it short, I provide guarantees that I will have one-on-one on you if my system does not work, and my system will works for other surrounding of you and deliver, will you call me back for one-on-one? Most likely not. Exactly the same when I talk about your book. If you want to pre-sell your book, offer 15 minutes private interview with the author and see how many will pay you $20 to get 15 minutes with you. In a record I know with someone, she's unique. She sold about 7,000 copies. She got zero requests.
So the people bought it on the promise of a 15-minute interview, but they never followed.
They never exercise it. And for me, for my 12 streams of income,
yeah.
It's the same for me. I pre-sold it, and nobody actually called me.
Yes.
No, nobody called me, because these people bought it like 2-3 months ago.
Well, yeah.
And nobody gave me a call.
Mm-hmm.
But they also have access to me in different venues, so... So
but
this
they give you a call, it's an opportunity for you to push them into a funnel.
Yes.
Yeah.
So because when we stand and say, give the offer of 15 minutes free, you'll come say, oh, I'm damn busy to even to come to your events, my friend. Why am I? Don't worry. The statistics showed less than 7% will call. Okay. Any discussions on 14? Any professional salesman, and if you want to understand, if you go to my personal Twitter on Saturday and Friday, Saturday and Sunday, you will see I'm celebrating with friends a specific event. But there was a specific tweets are my feedback on what happened in a parallel event where the speakers was messing it up. So they were messing it up.
Oh, okay.
So you can read the sequence. There is a specific hashtag you will understand, and this hashtag will be the celebration and everything. But on my W Badawi Twitter, you can see and you will understand. Because as I told you, we don't know. I cannot explain to you why it works. Like these people here, when they wrote in 1992, they said the marketing magazine has published the result of a survey to determine the most persuasive selling words. You discover easy, proven, save money, guaranteed, guarantee, health, happiness, love, and result. So you can discover an easy and proven way to save money and help guarantee your future health and happiness. Buy a home in one of America's finest community. You will love the results. So this is the actual sentence, which include all the words. Okay? Nobody will predict or has a model or has a crystal ball to predict this word. So we don't know why they do work. And to the impartiality of the analysis, this was done on a specific demographic. And we try. So many of the tools we say it's assessment, it's assumption. You apply it to practice, it works. If it does not work for you, we can tweak it with other alternatives. But we don't know why it works. And if anybody will tell you they know why, they lie. This is the truth of marketing. Marketing is just implementation of assumptions. And you have the window opportunity. So many of them, one of them actually in particular was very good program, I know, but the sales presentations of it was, I went even to the extent to write a tweet saying, I'm not, it's maybe me, I'm very critical of people, or I'm playing in a completely different league. And that's why I cannot play with this league. I'm not saying this, I make more money than them, but I see the league differently. Anyway, number 15, what are the three words that capture the benefit you provide?
Simple, supportive, success.
Three S's. Did you do this exercise before?
No.
I just listed out of here.
So I have one here.
My sheet, right? So
yeah, I have one here which is
progress.
I have one here which is called protect your rights, enjoy your freedom, and fulfill your obligations. These are for this particular business I have here. So what are the three words that capture the benefit you provide?
I like that, enjoy your freedom.
Okay, any sharing?
Yeah, I've got a few words. One is breakthrough results, satisfaction, accomplishment.
Denise?
enjoy your freedom. Retirement feels great. Retirement is fulfilling.
Okay. Now, you want to go to number 16, which basically write some potential taglines. So what are the potential taglines you can have? Marcel, you want to share?
What I had before, the simplest way on how to eat your elephant.
Do you have others? Because the exercise here is you write some potential taglines, then number 17, you can narrow them.
Yeah.
And number 18, you can have your final tagline. If you, it's
work in progress.
I have one that's called "Win Your Success."
yeah, you have to be careful. Oh, by the way, when your brand is actually trademarked,
is "Win Your Success." Yeah.
Is "Win Your Success" trademarked?
And when was your brand is a trademark, and how? And how do you build a build a brand is actually a trademark I own as well. So
success hasn't been linked to it.
Just be careful. Be careful because
he knows lawyers. Be careful.
Some
see if I can get the domain name, Win Your Success.
Well, there you go.
No, you wouldn't. You will not. You will not. Yeah. Just make sure when you get this into this level, we have to be careful of that's when we get the final tagline. So this is the standard exercise for a branding. There is one question back and three questions I don't want to do it. But anyway, that's why there are 19, not 22. They're originally 22. This is the standard practice till 2014. After 2014, what should we do? Exactly like what you did. You went online and look for the other words. You went online and you search for the tagline. You see who else here has similar tagline, because if you want to come and say, I am unique in what I offer, and this is a complete perception from engagement perspective, you come and convince me here in 16 questions or 17 questions that what you offer is unique,
mm-hmm.
and we understand your integrity and dignity, that they do exist. And then you give me a tagline where I go and find somebody using it. Before you, it means what?
You're not unique.
You are not unique.
And you don't have integrity.
Okay. I don't want to say it in this way, but this is where it's considered. Like, that's why when we come and say, a standard branding company will not be able to get you through, because it's not about you. You want to stand outside the noise with as much as you can of authenticated message. So all of this was in my brain when I sent you this email yesterday.
Yeah.
Because I got you. Like, I like to watch this show, to be honest with you. When I was at the university, I never missed the show. I never understand the slogan was a Jewish slogan.
I had no idea.
Okay.
The live long and prosper?
Huh?
Osprey is a derivative according to what Weil found.
And I send you this from Wikipedia. It
yeah.
didn't. It was not from any place, you know. I just I do my due diligence on,
yeah.
and what I was looking for is images for new book, for your book. That's
Spock
it.
Spock stolen.
Sorry.
Spock stolen, isn't that from?
You can't. I don't know if it's stolen, but they probably had some wisdom behind that.
It's a Jewish word, a statement which have been taken to Star Wars, Star Trek. And the Canadian actor who passed away is the one who used to say it. And their symbol, like this,
mm-hmm.
is a symbol of that. I have it on my Facebook page, and all of you are connected to me on Facebook. I just have the black hand with the writing on it.
When your success is taken.
Yeah, I know. I know.
Plan B.
I was just seeing.
Okay, so the last question. So you should come up with taglines.
Yes.
You should come up to narrow them, and you state your final tagline. The last question, which is what's important. What are the specific words, catchphrases, and sentences do you think will make emotional connections and help spark purchases? Okay. Sales training is a sales process, is a training. People will go to be trained as a salesman. They are not born as a salesman. Part of the sales training is you need to equip your team and yourself first with what are the trigger, what are the statement, what are the phrases, what are, so how do you answer this question? You say, okay, if I know my client and he has a need, how he will express this need? Okay, if I want to offer my service, what are the phrases and the sentence I can use to express my services? If I want to talk about values, what are the, so this is what I'm looking for you, is to fill this page and maybe have a couple of other pages with just saying, like, here is a dictionary of anybody who will come in my circle. These are the set of words and sentences that he will use. As if when you go to this meetup, take a recorder with you and record yourself when you describe your market and come back with the list. The more you have here, the better you can build a website, the better you can get, you can build a manual, the better you can build anything you want.
So I'm writing on the air, I kind of came up with another tagline. I got two, like, personalize your retirement and enjoy life all your life.
I think one of them would be make the rest of your life count.
Okay, so this is will conclude the exercise of the brand, big brand exploration.